India calls UK's vaccine stand discriminatory, warns of reciprocal action after the UK says that even fully vaccinated Indians will have to self-isolate for 10 days. The US, however, will allow restriction-free travel for Covishield vaccinated Indians from November. Top seer who died by suicide, Narendra Giri's closest aide, Anand Giri, is arrested and booked for a betterment. UP Chief Minister visits Prayagraj, says culprit won't be spared. The Enforcement Directorate begins a money laundering probe after heroin disguised as talcum powder is seized at a Gujarat's port. It is estimated to be worth a whopping 21,000 crore rupees. Now, India has sent a strong message to the United Kingdom a day after UK said that fully vaccinated Indians would continue to have to self-isolate for 10 days if they travel to the UK. India has called UK's stand discriminatory and warned of reciprocal action if the issue is not resolved.
Amid the growing furore over the UK's decision to consider those who have received both doses of Covishield as unvaccinated and requiring them to self-isolate for 10 days, India has made it clear that it considers this policy discriminatory and will reciprocate in kind if required.
The basic issue is that here is a vaccine, Covishield, which is a licensed product of a UK company, manufactured in India, of which we have supplied 5 million doses to the UK at the request of the government of the UK. We understand that this has been used in the national health system. And therefore, non-recognition of Covishield is a discriminatory policy. The Honorable External Affairs Minister, from what I understand, has raised this issue strongly with his counterpart, the new Foreign Secretary of the United Kingdom. If we don't get satisfaction, we would be within our rights to impose reciprocal measures.
External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar also tweeted about discussing the matter with the British Foreign Secretary Liz Truss on the sidelines of the high-level 76th session of the UN General Assembly. As criticism intensifies, with Congress leaders Jairam Ramesh saying that UK's decision smacks of racism and Shashi Tharoor calling it offensive and discriminatory, what has come as a shot in the arm for India is the United States' announcement of new relaxations for foreign travellers. From the 1st of November, there will be no restrictions on travel to the US for fully vaccinated foreign visitors. The US CDC has clarified that this includes all vaccines that have been approved for emergency use by the WHO, which means Covishield vaccinated Indians will be allowed, but for now not those who have received the other India-made vaccine, Covaxin.
The other big story a day after Narendra Giri, the head of the top religious body Akhil Bharatiya Akhada Parishad, was found dead at his Uttar Pradesh's Prayagraj residence. His closest disciple has been arrested. The police have filed an FIR against Anand Giri. Kamal Khan and Alok Pandey report.
High-profile visits to Prayagraj by UP's top politicians. To mourn the alleged death by suicide of Mahant Narendra Giri, the head of the Akhada Parishad, India's largest body of saints. Already a war of words has broken out on allegations of whether there was wrongdoing behind the death.
पूरा देश सच्चाई जानना चाहता है, साधु संत सच्चाई जानना चाहते हैं कि आखिरकार क्या हुआ है, किन परिस्थितियों में ऐसी घटना घटी।
कल की घटना को लेकर के बहुत सारे साक्ष्य कलेक्ट किए गए हैं। पुलिस की एक टीम जो यहाँ के एडीजी जॉन, आईजी रेंज और डीआईजी प्रयागराज एक साथ मिलकर के टीम वर्क के साथ इस कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ा रहे हैं। एक एक घटना का पर्दाफाश होगा, दोषी अवश्य सजा पाएगा।
The UP police has arrested this man, Anand Giri, a protege of the deceased Akhada Parishad head, till a few months ago, when he was expelled by the dead seer over allegations of fraud and financial mismanagement. Anand Giri had also accused Narendra Giri of fraud.
मैं सच या झूठ बोल रहा हूँ, उसके लिए चाहे तो सरकार की मदद लेकर के नारकोटिक टेस्ट भी मेरा कराया जा सकता है।
But withdrew his allegations.
कान पकड़ करके अपनी सारी गलतियों की सबसे पहले माफी मांगता हूँ, क्षमा मांगता हूँ यहाँ से।
This video from a patch up a few days later showed Anand Giri seeking forgiveness at the feet of his mentor, but the police suspect it was short-lived. The FIR against Anand Giri was filed by a colleague of Mahant Narendra Giri, the seer who died by suicide. It alleges that Narendra Giri had confided in this colleague multiple times that Anand Giri was harassing him, but it does not say how. Two other disciples have been detained for questioning, Sandeep Tiwari and Adya Tiwari. Both of them stayed with Narendra Giri. The police said the arrests are based on a suicide note found near Narendra Giri's body, which mentioned Anand Giri and the two other people. The note said the three were harassing Narendra Giri. Police sources say the Akhada Parishad owns property worth crores in Prayagraj and elsewhere in the country. And financial matters could have played a part in the top seer's suicide. There was tension in the Parishad over who would succeed Narendra Giri, police sources have claimed. With elections early next year and with Hindutva emerging as a main campaign pivot for the BJP, there will be pressure on the UP government to come up with answers to the death of this prominent Hindu saint. With Kamal Khan, Rajesh Gupta and Nitin Gupta, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.
Meanwhile, Anand Giri has called it a conspiracy and alleged murder.
ये बहुत बड़ा षड्यंत्र है, हम गुरु शिष्य के बीच में कभी कोई विवाद नहीं रहा, जिन लोगों ने सीधे तौर पे गुरुजी को ब्लैकमेल करके जो पैसा कमाया उन लोगों की साजिश है और उस साजिश के तहत उनकी हत्या हुई है। उन्हीं की हत्या में जानबूझकर के मेरे नाम का आना ये षड्यंत्र का स्पष्ट रूप है।
Now, five men who claimed to be from a group called the Hindu Sena were arrested by the police for vandalizing the official residence of Hyderabad MP Asaduddin Owaisi at Delhi's Ashoka Road. The incident took place on Tuesday evening. Deputy Commissioner of Police has said that five people were arrested for their alleged involvement in the incident. A police case has been registered.
यही तो रेडिकलाइज्ड हो चुके हैं लोग और इनके रेडिकलाइजेशन की जिम्मेदारी बीजेपी सरकार पर आती है। तो यही तो हम बता रहे हैं कि एक सांसद के घर पर अगर इस तरह हमला होगा तो क्या मैसेज जा रहा है पूरे देश में, पूरे दुनिया में।
नाउ बंगाल बीजेपी हैज अ न्यू बॉस, प्रोफेसर सुकांतो मजुमदार, रिप्लेसिंग दिलीप घोष जस्ट टू डेज आफ्टर बीजेपी एमपी बाबुल सुप्रियो स्विच्ड ओवर टू द तृणमूल कांग्रेस एंड लेफ्ट द सैफरन पार्टी रेड फेस्ड। The 41-year-old new BJP chief is brushing off the exit and that of four MLAs to Trinamool Congress.
In what indeed a smooth change of guard, no resentments on display. The only thing the new and the old boss of BJP Bengal couldn't seem to agree on was, of the many challenges before it, what is the biggest?
The main challenge is to save the Bengal. The democracy is totally abolished by this Trinamool Congress. So restoration of democracy and to stop this elimination of this Bengal.
The Trinamool, indifferent to BJP's bid to set its house in order after the assembly poll debacle. But it warned the Saffron Party of more shock exits like Babul Supriyo's and Ghar Wapsi's of its MLAs.
BJP has been totally rejected by the people of Bengal and it is very difficult for them to resurface. Many people, many leaders rather, they have in contact with us from different political parties including the BJP.
Indeed, Sukanto Majumdar faces multiple challenges, including internal power tussles like those rumoured between Dilip Ghosh and ex-TNC minister turned BJP's poster boy in Bengal, Shubhendu Adhikari. And not much time to make his mark. Civic polls are likely soon and just days away, Bhavanipur.
Bhavanipur, big challenge right away.
Big challenge for Mamata Banerjee, not for us.
With Anirudh Tripathi, Anjiri Shankar, Monideepa Banerjee, NDTV.
Now, Delhi Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party leader Arvind Kejriwal visited Goa to bolster his party's prospects in the state, which goes to polls early next year. Kejriwal made it clear that unemployment and jobs for locals is going to be a key issue for his party. His visit to a prominent temple and church has also drawn attention of those watching the political situation in the state.
मैंने सुना है सावंत साहब ने अनाउंस किया है कि वो डोर स्टेप डिलीवरी ऑफ सर्विसेज शुरू करेंगे, मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई। पर मेरा एक कहना है कि जो दिल्ली में काम हो रहे हैं वो उसको कॉपी कर रहे हैं, तो जब ओरिजिनल अवेलेबल है तो डुप्लीकेट की क्या जरूरत है।
द दिल्ली चीफ मिनिस्टर सेटिंग द टोन फॉर हिज पार्टीज इलेक्शन कैंपेन इन गोवा। केजरीवाल विजिटेड अ टेंपल एंड अ चर्च, विजिट्स दैट ड्रू अ लॉट ऑफ अटेंशन। The key announcement, unemployment benefits of rupees 3,000 a month and allowances of rupees 5,000 for families dependent on tourism and mining, if the Aam Aadmi Party comes to power.
Private jobs are not reserved for Goans. We will bring a law to reserve 80% of the private jobs also for Goans.
Kejriwal's two-day visit coincided with the BJP's Goa in charge, Devendra Fadnavis, also being in Goa.
Congress' avastha atyant vaait hai. अलीकडच्याच काळामध्ये आप पक्षाने देखील बऱ्यापैकी बॅनर पोस्टर लावले आहेत। राज्य चालवायला, देश चालवायला विचार लागतो, नीती लागते, रीती लागते, अराजकतेने देश चालू शकत नाही।
The Congress has repeatedly accused the Aam Aadmi Party of helping the BJP. But in a state where most of its own MLAs went to the BJP, it may find it difficult to explain that charge.
I remember last election in Goa, Mr. Kejriwal and his half of his cabinet was in Goa repeating exactly what they are saying today. So I don't want to comment on a party which is, let them do what they have.
Political analysts say Goa fits perfectly into the Aam Aadmi Party's scheme of things. With the Congress depleted this time, it'll have to work really hard to match its earlier performance, and the Aam Aadmi Party's gains are more likely to come at the cost of the Congress than the BJP. With Sonakshi Chakrabarty in New Delhi, Saurabh Gupta, NDTV.
Welcome back. Prime Minister Modi's Swachh Bharat initiative was driving for an open, defecation-free India by building thousands of toilets across the country. But what happens when there is a toilet but no house to live in? A family in Mehboob Nagar district of Telangana has been living inside a toilet, cooking and sleeping there as they have no house to live in.
This toilet built by the government for economically weaker sections has turned into a home for Sujata and her two children. A stone slab placed over the commode serves as a platform on which she cooks. There is a gas cylinder placed next to it. So also a few vessels, clothes and other meager belongings.
My name is Sujata. I am here. I am here. I am here. I am here. ఇంట్లోనే ఉంటున్నాం. ఇంట్లోనే వర్షం పడితే పిల్లలు వండుకుంటున్నారు, మేము కూర్చుంటాం. ఇంకా వర్షం వెళ్ళినాక మళ్ళీ తెల్లారినాక వండుకుంటాం సార్. మేము ఇంట్లో ఎమ్మెల్యే రాలే, ఎవ్వరు రాలేదు, ఎవ్వరు చూసిపోలే, ఇట్లా చూసిపోలే.
సుజాతాస్ హస్బెండ్ హ్యాడ్ డైడ్ 6 years ago. 2 years ago, their home was washed away in rains, after which they had nowhere to go and made this toilet their home.
చాలా చేస్తుంది ఇద్దరు పిల్లలతోని భర్త చనిపోయిండు, అత్త ఇద్దరు పిల్లలు ఆమె సంసారం చేస్తుంది. కానీ మీకు దయచేసి ఈమెనన్న చూసి ఎస్సీలకు ఇంత ఇండ్లు గవర్నమెంట్ నుండి సామగ ఇవ్వాలని కోరుతున్నాను.
వానకు నీళ్ళకు లేచి కూర్చుంటున్నారు సార్. తెల్లాలు నిద్ర లేదు కంటికి, పిల్లలు ఇద్దరు ఇళ్ళ పెట్టుకొని పండుకుంటుంది. ఇంత ఇల్లు కట్టి ఇల్లు కట్టి దానికి ఓట్లు మీకు వేస్తారు.
ద టీఆర్ఎస్ గవర్నమెంట్ హెడ్ అనౌన్స్ డబుల్ బెడ్రూమ్ హౌసెస్ ఫర్ ద పువర్ బిఫోర్ ది ఎలక్షన్స్. జస్ట్ లాస్ట్ మంత్ దే లాంచ్ ద దళిత్ బంధు స్కీమ్, by which every scheduled caste family is to get 10 lakh rupees. Sujata has not got the benefit of either of these schemes. The Mehboob Nagar collector says the government had paid compensation last year after rains, but Sujata had not got her house repaired. Now land has been sanctioned for a small house for the family. Uma Sudhir, NDTV.
The Enforcement Directorate has initiated a money laundering probe after the seizure of 3,000 kilograms of heroin from a Gujarat port. It is estimated to be worth a whopping 21,000 crore rupees.
The Department of Revenue Intelligence has recorded what's said to be the largest drug haul. 3 tons of heroin worth over 20,000 crore rupees from Mundra port in Gujarat, which has alarmed other agencies as well. This heroin is from Afghanistan, according to the DRI officials, who say the consignment was routed through Iran's Bandar Abbas port to Mundra port in Gujarat in the guise of talcum powder.
Kuch do consignment jo ki darya mark se
हिंदुस्तान में आ रहे हैं और उस दोनों कंसाइनमेंट के अंदर ड्रग्स है ऐसी एक इंटेलिजेंस मिली थी। उस फिजिकल वेरिफिकेशन के बाद पता चला कि वो दोनों कंसाइनमेंट के अंदर 20 किलो की जो एक बड़ी बैग रही थी, उस बड़ी बैग के अंदर 3 लेयर में ये ड्रग्स भेजा गया था जो कि हेरोइन था।
नाउ द एनफोर्समेंट डायरेक्टरेट हैज इनिशिएटेड अ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग प्रोब। द सीजर हैज ट्रिगर्ड अ नेशनवाइड हंट। A Vijayawada-based couple has been arrested on September 18th by the DRI Chennai team and they have been taken into custody. The consignment's bill of entry had the company's name. Further investigation is underway. However, the Andhra Pradesh police says that their investigation shows the heroin was intended for Delhi and not Vijayawada.
आखिर क्या कारण है कि पिछले कुछ वर्षों में मादक पदार्थों यानी ड्रग्स की तस्करी करने वालों का सबसे प्रिय रास्ता गुजरात हो गया।
NDTV ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट।
एंड दैट्स अ रैप ऑन दिस बुलेटिन फ्रॉम द एंटायर टीम। थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग। गुड बाय।